Hi everybody, it's Steve coming to you, well, not really live, but kind of live, from my garage. It's the only place in this house where I can record without waking somebody up. Please ignore those yellow things, really distracting for me while I record. But anyway, my group's video is about Act 5, Scene 1. Leading up to, we've seen that Mark Antony and Octavius have gotten together, and they're making decisions about the future of Rome, basically, because Octavius is Julius Caesar's nephew, so he's kind of in the lineage for power, and we know that Brutus and Cassius and the other conspirators have started an army to challenge Mark Antony and Octavius's government, and basically in hopes to regain power. We have seen that the ghost of Julius Caesar has appeared to Brutus, so we do know that something is amiss. And in this scene, we need to look out for some bird imagery that we saw from Trisha's presentation. So there's some more blood imagery. Actually, I say bird imagery. A lot of animal imagery. A lot of using animals to describe characters and their personalities or attributes, how they've behaved in the past. So, keep an eye out for that. I think that's basically it. Because of the way this assignment has worked out, there's two versions of the same video within this one YouTube video. The first one is, the script was very heavily cut down. So there are exact words that can be found in the text in the right order, but there's a whole lot missing. The second part will basically have every bit of the text, but it'll be in silent film form, so it'll be kind of like having subtitles. For the first one, it will be in the little box here. Well, it's not here right now, but hopefully I'll figure it out. And you can click on the attic, and Lewis Atticus, and you can go to that part of the video. Or if you want to skip straight to the silent movie, you can click on the hook things. Do you have a staring contest? Go. I'm still going strong. You're going down. You never win. You never win the staring contest. Ever. Ever. Aha! You blinked. Oh, you didn't? I didn't blink either, so. Apparently it's funny that I do that with my hair. So, yeah, I totally just now got back from shooting one of the other group's videos, so I think they're the last scene, so you know, keep an eye out for this guy right here. My head is hard. It's not even that late. Why am I so tired?
Antony, our hopes are answered. You said the enemy would not come down. It proves not so. They mean to warn us, answering before we demand.
I know, they could be content to visit other places, thinking in our thoughts that they have courage, but 'tis not so. The enemy comes immediately. Octavius, lead your battle upon the left.
Upon the right, I keep thou the left.
Why do you cross me?
I do not cross you, but I will do so.
They would have parley.
Stand fast, Antonius. Talk. Shall we give sign of battle?
No, Caesar. We will answer on their charge. The generals have some words.
Stir not until the signal.
Words before blows, countrymen.
Not that we love words better as you do.
Good words are better than bad strokes, Octavius. In your bad strokes, Brutus, you give good words. Witness the hole you have made in Caesar's heart, crying, Long live, hail Caesar. Antony, the posture of your blows are yet unknown. Villains, you showed your teeth like apes and fawned like hounds, and bowed like bondsmen kissing Caesar's feet, whilst Casca, like a cur, struck Caesar on the neck. Thank yourself, this tongue had not offended if Cassius ruled.
I draw a sword against conspirators. When the sword goes up again, never, till Caesar's wounds be avenged, or till Caesar have added slaughter to the swords of traitors.
Caesar, thou cannot die by traitors' hands, unless thou bringest them with thee.
I was not born to die on Brutus' sword.
If thou wert the noblest of thy strain, young man, thou couldst not die more honorable.
A schoolboy, worthless of honor, joined with a masquer and a reveler. Come, Antony. If you dare fight today, come to the field. If not, when you have the stomachs. The storm is up. All is on the hazard.
Lucius, a word with you.
My lord.
Messala, this is my birthday. Messala, be my witness. Coming from Sardis, two eagles fell, and there they perched, feeding from our soldiers' hands. This morning, are they gone? In their steads, ravens, crows, and kites fly over our heads as we were prey. Their shadows seem fatal, under which our army lies.
Believe not so.
But I believe partly, for I am fresh of spirit and resolved to meet all perils very constantly.
Even so, Lucius.
Brutus, the gods today stand friendly. We may lead on our days to age. If we lose this battle, then this is the last time we shall speak.
I did blame Cato for the death he did give himself. I know not how, but I find it cowardly to prevent.
If we lose this battle, you are contented to be led in triumph through Rome?
No, Cassius, think not that Brutus will go bound to Rome. But this day must end that work that the Ides of March begun. Whether we shall meet again, I know not. Farewell, Cassius. If we do meet again, we shall smile. If not, this parting was well made.
Farewell, Brutus. If we meet again, we'll smile indeed. If not, 'tis true. This parting was well made.
Oh, that a man might know the end of this day ere it comes. But it sufficeth that the day will end, and then the end is known. Come, away.